Namaste, beautiful yogis. Today we are doing a serenity morning routine. For more routines like this, come to my website alikamenova.com, where I have over 300 routines, full classes, full length classes, and I'll see you there. Let's begin. Starting by bringing the feet parallel to each other, outer edges of the feet parallel to each other, spreading the toes wide open and finding the four corners of each foot, pressing that down. So we're establishing foundation and building everything up from the foundation. Lifting up, building up, finding our core, our connection with our midsection and activating that. If you're building your muscles in your midsection now and they're not that strong, imagining that strong connection. Otherwise, activating it, feeling the core, powering up the core. Roll the shoulders back and down. Feel your posture aligning itself to where there is very little effort in standing, finding the equilibrium in your stance. And let's open the palms of the hands forward. Feeling the chest open, the back wide, the shoulders back and down, the head lifting, standing tall. Nice deep inhalations followed by complete exhalations. Firing up the breath, Ujjayi breath, deep. Creating that sound, that ocean-like sound as you exhale and as we inhale. Sitting back, chair. Inhale, lifting up. Exhale, the hands behind you, interlacing the fingers. Chair. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding forward. Hands behind you, interlacing. You can bend your knees slightly and look over to your right and left. One more time, right and left. And we're going to reach over with the hands and the left shoulder, lifting up over to the right, reaching over to the opposite side, lifting the right shoulder, hands pressing over to the left. One more time, finding freedom in the chest and shoulders, neck. All right, and now lowering down, hands pressing away from the back, release the hands down, hands on the shin bone, straight back, look ahead of you. Spread the fingers wide open, step it back, plank. Lower down, cobra. And back into downward facing dog. Here, I want you to scoop your elbows in and slightly forward without locking them, so that your shoulders are away from your ears. Gently allow the heels to drop down, as far down as your body allows. No competition here, they don't need to be on the ground. But if they are on the ground, gently pressing them down, otherwise gently pressing, stretching the calves and the tendons in the ankles down. Inhale the right leg up and open the right hip. So here we are going to draw a few circles with the knees, a few circles with the ankles. Square the hips, open the right leg over to the right. Press it back up, step it through, high lunge. Let's bring the hands behind us, interlacing, open the chest, look up. Lower down, Hunger Warrior. Coming halfway up, let's drop the back heel down and open into side angle, hands pressing behind you, elongating the spine. Let's bring the right hand down, left hand up and over. Bring the right hand all the way down, take side plank. Take 3-point plank, reaching with the left hand forward, and let's take chaturanga, up dog, optional second chaturanga, down dog. Take the left leg up, and let's draw a few circles with the bent knee. Breathe, and a few circles with the ankles. Square the hips, open the leg over to your left, even the shoulders out. Press it back up, step it through. Come up. Exhale, hands behind you, interlacing the fingers, open the chest, lifting through the chest. Combo warrior, lower down. Drop the back heel down, come halfway up, side angle with the clasp behind or with the hands clasping. Great, let's bring the left hand down, reaching with the right hand up and over the head. Drop the left hand down, side plank. Squeezing the inner thighs together, great. A 3-point plank and plank. Very good. Chaturanga, up dog. Let's look over to the left and to the right. One more time. And back to chaturanga or straight back to down dog. Inhale the right leg up, open the hip, lifting the knee high, reaching here, step it through, high lunge, interlacing the fingers behind you, open the chest, lift up, lower the chest halfway down, drop the back heel down, side angle. Very good. Back to high lunge and we're going to twist here, facing the chest towards the right leg. Drop the left hand down, right arm up, reaching over the head. Side plank. Frontal kicks, touching your toes here, so we're just going to kick forward and reach back over the head. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 3-point plank, chaturanga. Up dog. Optional second chaturanga if you want to work on your upper body strength. And core, down dog. Let's continue. Left leg comes up, open the hip.
lifting the knee high, keeping the shoulders aligned. Stepping through. High lunge.
Exhaling the hands behind you, reversing the clasp, open. Lower down halfway, side plank, drop the back heel down, and really lengthen the torso. Both sides of the torso are lengthening, elongating the tailbone. Down, core is active. Let's twist here, so lower the chest, parallel to the floor, and twisting the chest towards the left leg. Exhale and use the power of your core here. Right hand down, left arm up. You can reach over the head. Light on that right shoulder. Great. Side plank. And we're going to do our, toe touches here. So let's go for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, steady. 7, 8, 9, 10. And you can move into your plank. Holding here. And to round this practice up, we're going to work for a moment on the upper body, core in, tapping your shoulders. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're going to do the same, but we'll focus on the alignment even more. And when you tap your shoulders, we're going to try to minimally move the torso. So instead of twisting into the move, we're going to try to be very steady here. Let's go for 10 more. 1, 2, core fires up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Chaturanga. Up dog. Chaturanga. Down dog. Inhale the right leg up, step it through, high lunge. Bring the hands behind your head, just above the neck without clasping. And imagine that your spine is a rainbow and we're opening the chest and arching into that rainbow, and the neck is a part of your spine. So your neck is elongating here. We're not pressing, compressing the neck and looking up. We're elongating the back of the neck. Pressing the elbows out. Good, let's open the arms out. And here we're going to draw a few circles with the fingertips reversing the direction. Great, take warrior two. Reverse the warrior. From here, side angle. Either with a clasp, if you cannot do clasp, stay in side angle. Back to warrior two, straightening the leg, reaching forward, pivoting. And lower down, triangle. Lengthening through the crown of the head again. Both sides of the torso are lengthening. Excellent. Let's walk the hands to the center of the mat if you're using a mat. And lower down here. Feet are parallel to each other. Forward fold. Wide legged forward fold. And move your body here in a wave-like motion, side to side, changing the direction. Shoulders may be drawing figure eights.
Great, walk to the front, plank, chaturanga, up dog, optional second chaturanga, down dog, left leg comes up, coming up, high lunge.
Let's bring the hands behind us, open, open the chest, find length in your back. Reach out to the sides, a few circles here with the fingertips. Opposite side. Warrior two. Reverse the warrior. Side angle. Stages to side angle, choose your where you're at wisely. Back to warrior two, reverse it. From here, pressing the hips back, elongating the spine, reaching forward, triangle pose, and you can start anywhere from above the knee and find your perfect spot where your body feels great and the alignment is great. So you want to be able to elongate the spine. Let the tailbone slightly lengthen the right and the left side of the body. Lift the arches of the heels. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Find ease. Find grace in this pose. You can reach forward. And from here, lower the hands down and take feet parallel to each other, wide-legged forward fold. A few more figure eights with the shoulders. And we're going to point the toes out and come up for plié. And here we're going to take the right toes up, reach over to your left, change sides, left toes, left arm. Again, a few more of those. Good. From here, we're going to start reaching side to side and extending one leg as we reach over. Left arm, right, left, right, side to side now. Pressing away, using the entire body, using your core. Pulling, moving fast, changing the direction, getting into whole internal organs, massaging everything with movement. Great. Let's move the shoulders. Let's look over the left shoulder, right shoulder. Left, right, twisting here, looking over the left, twisting, looking over the right. From here, we're going to step at the front in chair, hands in prayer, twist over to your left, right elbow to left knee. From here, balance, finding balance on your left leg and taking the right foot back in high lunge. Nice twist, clasp, maybe, only if possible. If not, maybe a year from now. You never know how much your body is willing to do yoga. From here, right hand glides forward. We're taking revolving half moon. Pressing the back heel away from the hips. From here, gliding back, revolving triangle, both pressing the right hip back, so we're getting a nice hip opener here. Both hands on the outside of the left foot, and we're going to glide that left foot out and deepen that hip opener. This is delicious. Excellent, step it back. Plank. Let's bend the knees and hover them over. Walk the feet a little closer and hover your knees over the ground, pressing your belly in. Great, from here, jump into chair. Hands in prayer, left elbow, right knee. Open that chest, shifting onto the right foot, take the left foot back. Maybe clasp here, maybe not. Listen to your body. Look down, take the left hand in front of you, revolving half. Step it back, square the hips, revolving triangle. Press that right hip back, lengthening through the spine, through the top of the head. Both hands are coming down on the outside of the right foot, and we're going to glide the right foot out and try to face your belly down, your torso down, so you're getting a stretch in the hip here. A nice, delicious stretch. Great, step it back. Plank, knees come down on the ground. Right hand, palm facing up, flats down. Back of the right shoulder down, looking up. Let's change sides, left side, palm of the left hand facing up, gliding it away from you. Back of the left shoulder down. Coming out of this, sit down, and we're going to take a forward bend. Inhale, coming up, and let's grab the left foot with both hands and either extend it halfway, or you can extend it all the way and bring it towards your chest. From here, bring the foot somewhere either on your triceps or a little higher over the shoulder and lift it here. Excellent, release. Opposite side, grab your foot with both hands. You can hold it halfway bent, you can even press it back behind your shoulder or straighten it. All right, get into that hip opener. As deep as you can, just climb up the inside of your knee as high as you can on your tricep. Open here, that should feel good in your hips. Very good. Wide-legged. Sit it down position. We're going to face the right leg here and peel the leg off the ground as much as you can. Maybe the entire leg. Really, really concentrating on the core here. Or maybe just lifting as much as you can. So facing here, lift one, two, and three. Opposite side, one, two, three, forward bend. Side to side reaching, forward bend. Twisting side to side. Soles of the feet together. Thank you.
Grab the backs of your knees, roll back,
and all the way to plie and plow.
Shoulders tense. Back to plow and slowly and gently roll out of plow. For Shavasana, you can extend your legs or bring the soles of the feet together. Lay down onto the ground. Arms of the hands facing up. Finding a very relaxed place for you so that you can bring that with you for the within your day, for the rest of your day, finding a place of stability, security, relaxation, energy, trust, faith, and taking that with you, finding the stability, the safety of your body and the safety of the ground, feeling the energy circulating through your veins, through your meridians, feeling that energy, feeling that safety, feeling that groundedness, feeling that content place, and taking that with you without too much of the extremes, because that tends to come on its own, but finding that center of contentment and peace and groundedness and taking that in your day rather than the extremes of sadness and too much excitement, finding the place in between is your rescue, as your safe place to come back to, and also as a place that you can nurture and build and bring with you into your day. So stay here and build, nurture that place for as long as you need to, and when you're ready you can slowly come out of Shavasana. And I'm wishing you a beautiful, productive, successful and serene day. Namaste.